So Calvin Harris came out with a pretty cool new music video called Feels. And they've kind of added these color effects into their music video where you kind of see this grass change from green to purple. And in a next shot, we've got Pharrell here with these crazy blending modes and green magenta colors. And that is exactly what we're going to recreate today inside Adobe Premiere Pro. And we arranged Katy, the actual Katy Perry here. It might not seem her, but that was because it's actually shot on a different lens. And you know, if you're using different lenses, your characters might seem or might look a little bit different. But trust me, this is the real Katy Perry right here. And we're going to change the grass here around her and her dress. We're going to make that blue as well. So that is going to be pretty cool. And then we've got the real Pharrell here. This was actually shot a month before the video clip, which is why he kind of has this curly hair. And we told him to shave that off for the actual video clip. You know, that is the truth story behind it. So we're going to take a look at how to create these awesome color effects here as well and kind of animate them over each other and blend some palm trees into it. So let's see how to create this. Let's get started. What up guys, Jordy here for CineCam.net and welcome again to a very exciting Premiere Pro tutorial. We're going to recreate these awesome color effects from the Calvin Harris video clip Feels. But before we're going to start, I first want to thank the sponsor of this video, which is Videoblocks Today. It's a huge library of stock footage, After Effects templates, backgrounds, overlays, video effects, and so on. And you can actually get a 7-day trial for free, so definitely make sure to visit the first link in the description below. So let's continue now with the tutorial. I've got a new sequence right here with these two clips in it. And we got Kim right here laying in the grass. Katy Perry laying in the grass right here. And what we're gonna do is open up the Lumetri color panel. And if you can't see this, head over to the window on top and just select Lumetri color right here. And the first thing you usually wanna do is head over into the basic correction and kinda add a bit more punch to it. And that will help us to select the specific color that we want to change. It can do that by increasing the saturation a tiny bit or also by adding some more contrast to that shot to give it some more punch. And also, and this is something that you have to pay attention to when shooting your video clip, and that is to make sure that you have a clear difference in your colors. So right here we've got this pink dress which really pops out and we can easily select that color. The same thing goes for the grass. Now if Kim right here would have laid down on the sand or something and we would want to change the color of that sand, and that is going to be pretty hard because that sand would come close to her skin tones, and that way we can't really select that color. But we've got a good example right here, and by the way, you can also download this project file for free. You can also find a link to it in the description below so you can practice along with this tutorial. So once you kind of give it some more punch, we're going to go into the secondary color correction, which is the HSL secondary. And on top right here, we have some controls to select the color that we want to change. And let's start with that grass. You can actually take the color picker right here to select a part of that grass. So that's one way to do it. And I find that it's usually not that accurate. So what I want to do is kind of manually go into the Hue, saturation, and luminosity or lightness control to specifically select the parts that I want. Now to visually see what we are selecting, I'm going to enable the mask right here by just selecting this box. And now I can see that I actually have already a big part of that grass selected. And going through these settings now, you kind of want to see how far you want to go. You want to increase the range of that Hue and kind of offset that perhaps that you are really selecting the green parts. The next thing is the saturation. Also here you can increase that range and kind of move that around until you find a good part that is selected. And then finally, we've got the luminosity that you can also increase so that you're very sure that you are selecting the right parts. And you always want to make sure that when you are selecting a certain color, that you are not selecting areas that you don't want to select. So that is Kim, for example, here, who's laying on the ground. Because if we would select, for example, more of that yellowish color, you will see that I'm selecting here as well. And that is not what we want to have. So I'm going to put this back to somewhere right here. And this looks fine to me. We can always go back into here to kind of change that. Deselect your mask, and now we're going to scroll down, and with these controls, we can change the color of that grass. So what I'm gonna do is just increase the tint, and that way we can kind of make that purple or reddish. By the way, if you wanna go beyond the 100 right here, then don't select that slider, but actually just increase the number of that value, and that way you can kind of really make that purple, as you can see. And now I'm also noticing that my mask wasn't really done so well. The edges here are just way too hard, so I kind of want to feather this, and we can do that from in here with the Hue, for example. We can select this bottom triangle to add a little bit more feathering to that. And you can see here what it kind of does. And that way now I am better selecting that grass and we don't have those hard edges as you can see. All right, this looks pretty awesome. And we are going to animate this right now. And that is done from the effects controls right here. And we've got the Lumetri color effect onto it from which we've changed here the colors of. And so I'm going to open up that HSL secondary in which we've been playing around the entire time. You can, by the way, see the exact same controls in here as well that you can see in the Lumetri window. And we're going to create a keyframe for the tint. So just create a keyframe for that. It's currently at its ending position. So what I'm gonna do now is go back in time and then just reset that value to 0. And you can do so by just clicking on the reset button and that will create a new keyframe for that default value. And when we are going to play this right now, you'll see that the colors will actually slowly shift to that purple color. And that is pretty cool. So this is really like the basis of how that secondary color selection works. Let's go quickly over the next example where we are going to change the dress of Kim, I mean Katie, and to do that I'm actually going to take a new Lumetri color effect. And what you can actually do is right click on that effect that we've just applied and say rename, and I'm going to rename this to grass, and that way I know that this is the secondary color correction for the grass. Next I'm going to head over to the effects library and just search for Lumetri. I'm just going to close those presets here and drag that Lumetri color effect to my effects controls. So now we have the Lumetri color twice in it. And I'm going to rename that second Lumetri color effect to dress. And that way I know that this here is the dress. And in the Lumetri window right here, you can also see it on top which one we have selected. So that is all fine. And with that selected, I'm going to select her dress. Again, we can use that color picker if you want so and click on her dress. And that will kind of select already the pink of her. Enable the masks that we can fine tune, and now we just kind of want to go through that. I know that this dress was very saturated.
We can definitely take a large range of that. Now we are running into a problem here, guys. We are also selecting the grass. And the reason for that being is because, well, we have made that grass kind of purple pinkish.
So we are also selecting that, and that is because we have first applied that effect onto it, and then we are doing the dress. So to fix that, very simple, what we're going to do is just move this Lumetri color here above that grass, and that way we are first going to select the pink, changing that to something like blue, and then we are going to make the grass purple.
And another thing we are running into, and this is what I believe a little issue with Premiere Pro, is that whenever we are going to select one of these colors,
the tap here on top will not change. It will always take like the last effect in your row
of the effects controls.
So we can't use the Lumetri window now anymore.
I kind of have to go into the effects controls, open up the HLS secondary in here,
and change my settings in here. But that's okay because they look actually exactly the same. So let's continue here. I'm going to try and select the biggest part of her dress, and this is just something that you really have to play with. Just increase that range here and just kind of go through that. Make sure that you're not selecting anything of her skin tones, which is not that easy. As you can see, we're already here selecting some of her skin tones. I believe so that those are her skin tones. Oh no, it's actually just some of the flowers that she has in her hair. That is okay. We can also change those. I believe that my mask is actually going pretty good. Perhaps just kind of fine tune this a bit more. Perhaps add a little bit more feathering to it that we don't have those hard edges. But this is actually coming out pretty good. I have that selected now, so I'm going to deselect my mask and just kind of go into
the temperature here and just kind of make that blue all the way.
Look at that, guys. If it is too saturated, also decrease the saturation a tiny bit, something like this. By the way, you can also just play around with other things in here like the contrast and such. Perhaps decrease that tint a bit more to the green side, something like this, so that it's not like too saturated, too hard blue, so that still kind of looks natural, that seems like she's wearing a blue dress right now. So we're going to create keyframes for the temperature, the tint, and the saturation, of which we have changed the colors of, and I'm actually want to select these keyframes, move them a bit more forward in time, because I want to start my animation a little bit later, somewhere right here. And before those keyframes, we're going to reset those values again. So just reset them all, and that will create keyframes for the default value. And that way, when I'm going to play this now, you will see that her dress will change into blue.
So by having this Lumetri effect twice on that clip, you can actually see that
we can first change the color of that grass, and next we can change the color of her dress. Kim, you are doing it awesome. I mean, Katie.
And let's go with Pharrell now, and he's dancing. Just look at those awesome dance moves here.
By the way, he just loves to wear that shirt. He wears it every day almost. I don't know why, but if it makes him feel good, you know what, just let him wear it.
It is pretty cool for this effect, so
thank you, Janik, for that. I mean,
Pharrell. So with the second coloring effect, let's have a quick look back at the example right here. We are not going to do that secondary color correction onto it. It works a little bit different and actually pretty simple to create. So let's see how we can do that. From the effects library right here, I'm going to look for invert. And it's right here, just drag that effect onto that clip, and already you can kind of see what it does here. It will invert all of those colors, but we can also select different modes on how it actually has to invert. And you can do that from the effects controls right here, we've got it right there, invert. And we are going to select a different channel value. In this case, we can select something like face prominence. This already gives something pretty cool, Janik the Smurf, or we can also go for something else like just that option right here. That will kind of give him some more yellowish skin tones, which is more natural than the blue. I kind of like this, so I'm going to animate it as well. And we can just do that with the second option here, like how much would you like to blend this effect with the original. So we're going to start with that, create a keyframe at 100%, where we don't see that invert effect, create a keyframe for it, just go a little bit forward in time and just bring that to zero. So right away, we already have like the first coloring effect, and this looks pretty awesome actually. The next thing we're gonna do is add that invert effect again to that clip. This is the second time that we're doing that. And this time I'm going to say that we are going to invert the green. And this will kind of give that green magenta look that we were also seeing in the video clip, but it's way too hard, but that is something that we are going to fix. So stay with me, guys. We're going to start by animating that blending mode right here first. So just create a keyframe for 100 and now just slowly let that go to green like that. So what I'm gonna do is duplicate that layer by holding down the Alt key on your keyboard and dragging that clip to channel number 2. And that way you can make a duplication of that. With the second layer selected, I'm going to remove the two effects that we've applied because we've also duplicated that and we don't want that. What we're actually gonna do is change the blending mode of that second clip to luminosity. And that way those saturations aren't so hard anymore. The same thing that you also want to do is from the Lumetri controls right here, I'm just going to scroll up and go into the basic corrections. I'm going to decrease that exposure here so that we can see the magenta a little bit better in the sand right here. But that of course depends on the shot that you have, but just know that you can kind of fix that with the exposure setting right here. Now that second clip here in a timeline, just zoom in a little bit more on that. What we're going to do with that is kind of fade that in at the point where we have that second animation starting here, so that it's somewhere right here. And so I'm just going to align that clip to it, right click onto it and say apply default transition. That way it will kind of fade in like so. And to really top this off, we're going to blend in some palm trees, like they've also done in their video clip. Now I got some amazing palm trees from Videoblocks. I just searched for palm trees and I got some right here because here in Belgium, there are no palm trees. So I just had to look that up for some stock footage. So I just downloaded this awesome shot right here and loaded it into Premiere Pro. I got it right here in my project panel right here, guys. And I'm just gonna select like a part from it and just drag that on top of that clip. Select that, go into the effects controls and we're going to blend that using the multiply. It's a bit too hard, so I'm going to decrease the opacity as well so that we can vaguely see the palm trees coming through. And also here, we wanna add that transition to it like so. And now you can see how Janik's dance moves are really coming out with those awesome color effects. I mean, Pharrell, of course. So let's have a look at the final results right here, where the grass is changing color and the dress of Kim too. And then we have Pharrell, who is putting off these awesome dance moves through these cool colorings effects that we've created with the invert effects. Alright guys, that was it again for this awesome tutorial. Make sure to check out the description below because you can find a link to the project file that you can download for free, and a link to Videoblocks, which I definitely recommend to check it out. Thank you so much for watching again, guys, and like always, stay creative.